I know Aswad on his word in asking questions of half knowledge. Okay, Bismillah. And your Rabbuka, ka. To Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, revealed the ayah to the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, your Lord, Allah Subhanahu, remember the event when your Lord, who? The Prophet Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala talking to Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Ta'ala Alaihi Wasallam.
So, sir, can I ask you a question in half of knowledge? What's the other half?
Marriage.
Then they learn the half. Your efforts. Okay, inshallah.
When the angel said that before this, they were jinnah, was it all inhabited on this edge? And that's where.
दुनिया में जो थे वो लोग देवर ऑन द अर्थ दुनिया ही में थे ये लोग यही फसाद मचा रहे थे ना जमीन वही तो बताया ना आपको कि आदम इस्लाम के पैदा करने से पहले इन सबको भगाया फरिश्तों को हुक्म दिया भगाओ समुद्र में फेंको समुद्र में डाला पहाड़ों में जंगलों में अभी भी आप जाएंगे तो यहाँ अभी भी बहुत हैं और काला जादू जो है ना ब्लैक मैजिक आपको पता है कि ज़्यादातर ये सी से ही होता है तो इसे डिफरेंट टॉपिक मैं भी इंशाल्लाह विल कम टू द आया आई विल टॉक अबाउट द ब्लैक मैजिक कैसे इस तरह होता है हाउ आई विल एक्सप्लेन टू दियर इंशाल्लाह एनीवे वेयर वी हैव बिफोर सोला Qala subhanaka, is it?
Was there any other
makhluk
with the jinn? Because you know
how the one... A lot, but Allah subhanaka is saying about us, about the human being and to us. Of course, he is Abul Alameen. Okay, different worlds. We are in one of the world. We are living one of the world of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of the wise person of Uliullah said, there are 70,000 world. Okay, now come to the ayat, otherwise I can't finish, okay. قَالُوا سُبْحَانَكَ لَا عِلْمَ لَنَا إِلَّا مَعَلَّمْتَنَا So I gave the tafsir of it or not?
Yeah.
We finish this one? Oh, yes. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Adam alayhi salatu wasalam to inform them about the asma. Now the asma, the names. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala basically taught Adam alayhi salatu wasalam the name of every single thing according to some scholars. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught Adam alayhi salatu wasalam the name of every single thing till the day of judgment. So even the one of them of us he said, even like the cups, this is the piala, piali, and this and that, every single thing, every single name Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. This is one tafsir. Alama Adam al-asma'a kullaha. So every single thing's name, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught him, and then Adam alayhi salatu wasalam got from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala this knowledge. And some scholars say, That every single thing. Some scholars say basically all asma sifatiya of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Some of the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the asma sifatiya name, the malaika they know, but they don't know all of them. The malaika they don't know all of them. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught every single name of His sifat. So anyway, it doesn't matter we go this tafsir or that tafsir, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala basically is shown to the malaika, see, you don't know or don't have that knowledge. So see this person, I just created him, now you can see his knowledge. So that's why the malaika, they said, oh Allah, we don't know much. Whatever you taught us, that's it. So these human being, they got this quality, mashallah, the knowledge, the ilm. And that's why, you know, the knowledge and ilm is the main thing, basically. But with that, so we can see the status of the human being. Of course, the iman, the faith, this without that, even the human being got the, a lot of knowledge, but there is no faith, he will be like the animal. A person who got, hasn't got the iman, he will be the like animal, but worse than that. أُولَٰئِكَ كَالْأَنْعَامِ بَلْهُمْ أَضَلُ. So these human beings, if they don't have the knowledge, the iman, the faith, this means they are worse than even pig. Worse than pig. Pig are better than this human being. Allah SWT says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنْ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ وَالْمُشْرِكِينَ فِي نَارِ جَهَنَّمَ خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا. And then he said, أُولَٰئِكَ هُمْ شَرُّ الْبَرِيَّةِ. The worst creation of Allah SWT. These human beings, if they don't have the iman, don't have the faith, okay, so then they will be the worst creation. And the other group in the ladina amanu wa salihati, ulaika hum khairul barya. So because of the faith and good deeds, these human beings are the best creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anyway, now so faith is very important. And on top of that, the knowledge, the ilm. The knowledge and ilm, alhamdulillah, because of this, so you can say that this, we human beings are the superior than the makhluk. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, according to Hadith Mawlana Qasim sahib Nanuti rahmatullahi alayhi, he said, manba'ul ilm. So basically, all the ilm Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala basically gave the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, through him, or because of him, we can say that all the Anbiya, all the Rasul, they got the knowledge with his wasila, because of him. And even the prophethood, all the prophets and all the messengers, they got the risala, they got the prophethood because of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give this status to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Anyway, when the malaika, they admitted, they said, yes, oh Allah, we got a very, very limited knowledge. Whatever you taught us, that's it. You don't know much. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, qala, he said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ya Adam, O Adam, ambi'hum, inform them, tell them, bi asma'ihim, the name of the dear name, the name which I taught you. So said every single name. Falamma, when Adam arisatus amba'ahum, he informed them, had informed them, bi asma'ihim, their names. So the malaika, they understood at that time, mashallah, see this human being. Just Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created him right in front of us. We can see him now. So straight away, he got the knowledge like this. Qala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then they understand the status or rank of Adam alayhi salam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Qala, he said, Alam aqul lakum, did not aqul, I say lakum to you. So I didn't say to you, in me, indeed, I a'lamu, I know, ghaiba, the unseen, as-samawati, the heavens, wal earth, the earth. So Allah SWT says to the malaika, I didn't tell you that I know the ghaib, the unseen of every single thing. The ghaib, the unseen of the heavens and the earth. I know. And as well as, wa a'lamu, and I know, and did I tell you that I know ma ma what tubduna you open wama and what you kuntum you were taktumun hide or conceal. So what you display or what you conceal, I know everything. What is in your inside heart, inside you, I know already. So basically what happened at that time, the malaika, they were talking about the human being, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala going to make this human being. And as well as in amongst the malaika, the jinn, Iblis, he was of course with them, and he got something else in his mind. What was malaika? They are masoom, do not commit any sin, but Iblis or jinn, they are, of course, they commit the sin. And then the Iblis hide many thing in his heart. What he said, that if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make this person is a amir for us, the leader for us, and then I'm not going to obey. So in this khitab, basically covering to the malaika, covering to the Iblis as well. So anyway, after that, now it is the time to show the status of human being. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Wa'id, and remember when, and remember when, Qulna, we have said, Lil malaikati, to malaika. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to the malaika? Usjudu, make sajda. To whom? Li Adama, to Adam. Fa, what happened? So sajadu, so malaika, they make the sajda, so they don't have any problem to do the sajda, illa, but Iblis. So Iblis basically, what happened? Abba, he refused or denied, was takbara, not only this, on top of that, wa and istakbara, so he was arrogant. Wa and kana, he became min in al kafirin, of the disbelievers. So he became, or he was, or he is from the disbeliever. Now, so basically, this is the translation. Now I'm going to give the small, the very brief tafsir of it. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to the malaika, this ayah says to the malaika, and then all the malaika, they made the sajda, except Iblis. Now question is, was Iblis from the malaika? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to the malaika. Okay, this means according to some tafsir mufassirin, even Hazrat Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, he said that jinn was from the malaika. So this means, so he was, Iblis was from the malaika, then he became Iblis afterward. So before he was fine. So that's why the ayah, if you see clearly, says is kunna lil malaikati and wal jinn. Allah subhanahu didn't say this. If you have said to the malaika, said to the jinn or Iblis to do such, Allah subhanahu said this to the malaika only. Understand? So according to some of mufassirin, they said that the Iblis was from the malaika, because he disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then he became Iblis. But if you see the Quranic ayah in Surah Al-Kahf, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says the same story. It qulna lil malaikati isjudu fasajadu, it qulna lil malaikati isjudu li adama, Tasjadu illa iblis. Kana minal jinni. In Surah Al-Kahf, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about them, about jinn, about iblis. Kana minal jinn. Did not say he is from the malaika. Understand? The Quranic ayah very clearly states there that he was from the jinn. Understand? So now, so which way we go? Whether we say the iblis was from the malaika or from the jinn. Quran states there very clearly, Kana minal jinn. And I tell you one thing, the beauty of the Holy Quran is Al-Quran yufassiru ba'duhu ba'dan. Quran gives the explanation, the tafsir in his ayah. Okay, if this ayah says something and they need any clarification, we can go to some other ayah, we can see that it will explain the ayah, the mujmal ayah. There's no details we can get from other ayah. So that's why for the Quran, so we do not give any verdict or get any opinion by this reading only one ayah. We have to go to full Quran, then you can get full knowledge, and then you can see, okay, now is this. You understand? So now, so this little malaika thing, come to here. Allama Baghawi rahmatullah alayh said this, there was a group of malaika. There was a group of malaika. So their name was jinn. Was jinn. And their duty was to guard the Jannah. To guard the Jannah. Understand? So jinn, there was a group of the malaika. So according to Allama Baghawi rahmatullah alayh, basically he was trying to say this, that he was from the malaika. You understand? That was his opinion. Now, what, if you ask me, okay, which way I go? My opinion is that Iblis was a jinn, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in Surah Al-Kahf very clearly. So what is the answer then of this ayah? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to the malaika. So in the malaika, he was there. You understand? Now we'll say in Arabic, basically, the taghliban, here's a word used, taghliban. Means that even though he wasn't an angel, but the thing is this, because he was with them, he was with them at that time. At that time he was there. So it's 99%, 99.99 are malaika, 1% is out of them. But the king, the Malikul Muluk, when give the order to everyone, that order will, cover to everyone. So that was two malaika. 99.99 means they sent to all of them, even though he was there. So there is no need to, take him out. So this is called taghliban. So for the taghliban, for the ghalba, the big majority is the big, 99.99. So you can imagine. So that's why something happened like this. Let's say if I say something to you students. Okay, so I say to students, maybe a person is the outsider. He just here, but he's not the permanent student. But if I say to, okay, do this homework, for example, do this. So I'm saying, I said to the students, covered everyone. So there's no need to say, okay, except a person who came for 5 minutes, he is not there. There's no need to say, just unless goes without saying. Saying to the, so now, because that order, so everyone must obey Allah's order, doesn't matter the malaika or any makhluk was there, must obey. That one was the one person was Iblis, So that's why we'll see that Taghriban, he was, because he was at that time amongst the Malaika, with them, that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to the Malaika, means he was included.
I don't want to ask you, but you know, the Malaika, they didn't have any desires, yeah? So if Iblis, if he was a Malaika, then he wouldn't have the desire to be free.
Khalas, this is my argument, this is my delay. No, that's fine. I said, see, because as I said to you, there are the opinions that they got this. Okay, even the jinn made by this, but this, that was the special kind of the malaika. Of the malaika. And it's like a human being, they got the different kind. Understand? So, like human being, a good, bad, this and their different qualities. So, the types of malaika, according to Allama Baghawi, we all have Abdul Ibn Abbas, is related to this? Okay.
Just all the
knowledge of
Abbas, is there any reference to that? Like in
he is Mufassir of Quran, the first Mufassir of Quran. Yes, many. Yes, yeah. Allama Qurtubi rahmatullah alayh, he has narrated in Tafsir
this Ikam Rahkam. Did they change their opinion? Or, you know, Quran is revealed bit by bit. There wasn't like
video. No, this fine. So, Sirkana min al jinni, and this one, Abdullah ibn Abbas, he according to him, he thought it's fine. Because the jinn, as I said, there was the type of the malaika was jinn too. Okay, there was a type of malaika, the one type of malaika, their name was jinn. That's why though, the jinn then malaika then as well, not all the jinn, particular. That's why when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to the malaika to take all other jinns to the sea, to the mountain, so Iblis was with them as well, he was, you know, taking them out. Is that Abdullah ibn Abbas or Zillat Alam? If you say something, this is the hadith of Abdullah ibn Abbas. Yes. So he's one of the big mufassir. He got all the evidence. Because my opinion is that he was a jinn. So that's why I go with this here. Okay, now. So this is one dispute. So as I said to you, that according to any, as I said, you want to say what is my opinion? I can say my opinion is that he was a jinn. Okay. And whatever he performed the ibadah, whatever he has done, basically, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows in his heart already. So he was doing this not for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to get the Khilafah. That's why he was worshipping. So that's why, you know, my Sheikh used to say always, if any murid, you know, if in his mind comes this thought of thinking that I'll be the Khalifa of my peer, this means he's gone. This person is gone because his objective is not to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Objective is to get to become Khalifa, then become Peer, become Sheikh, okay, after my Sheikh. So basically, and then maybe he's doing a lot. A person came to my Sheikh, he said, Hazrat, I have finished 25,000 times Quran Sharif. 25,000. Give me Khilafa because I become so, I got the rank, so high rank now. Sheikh said, okay, to get out. Finish, gone. So you finish the Quran for this, to get the Khilafah, to be a peer, go out. So understand, so this is very important that this, see the Iblis, he did not leave any space on the earth. He made sajda everywhere, but intention was bad. That's why he was gone. So, and then not only gone, you can see what Abba Wastakbara. He refused, and on top of that, Wastakbara. He became a takabbir, arrogant. Fafasaka an amdar. Then he out. Fasaka, he out from the order of his Lord. So he fisk, this fisk. A fisk, a person fasik, basically who is going out from the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why he called him fasik. That's the fasaka, that's the fasik. Fasik means a sinner, a person who is going out from the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's a fasik. A person who doesn't perform the salah, for example, is a fasik. Okay, the second thing, first is this, he refused. This is the one act he has done. The second act was istakbar. So arrogancy is a very, very dangerous thing. If any human being proud himself, basically he is the follower of Shaitan. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't like at all any person who proud himself. Because this is the against of our nature. Understand? Our nature is be ajiz. So we have to humiliate ourselves that we are nothing. But if you think maybe we are something, this is against our nature. So we are going against of our nature. You understand? That's why. So takabbur is very dangerous. When takabbara wada'ahu Allah, a person who got the arrogancy or the takabbur, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put him down. And this sort of person, he feel in his nafs that I am something. He feel this. In his nafs that yes, I am something, but in the eyes of people is nothing. No one will praise this mutakabbir person, a person proud. Do you see anyone? Oh, this man is very nice. No, everybody accuse. Sabne su gali dena. Everyone will say something bad about him. What is the point to person, you know? Saying thing, I'm something, I have done this, I am this, I am that, did I. I just saying, or what? People don't like this. Who are you? Understand? So it is very important. It is very important that we have to humiliate ourselves, saying anything. If something, mashallah, you have done, where is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives opportunity to this, to that. Not if we have done something, no, we are nothing. So we have to put ourselves down. And that's why a person who put himself down, man tawadu'a lillahi rafa'ahu Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will raise him then. And then everyone will praise this person. People will say, see, this man, he have done a lot of things, not prodding. This person got the knowledge, he's the, like a mountain of knowledge, but showing is nothing. Walking to the street like a normal person. Sitting with the people like a normal person. No special dress. No, people say, oh, this person is a different thing. No. That's what the quality of the Sahaba, our A'imma, our Shuyukh, sitting with the people. Showing that we are nothing, same as you. So very important. If you are very, very rich man, but don't proud on it. Pay thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but do not proud. So this kibir is a very dangerous thing. So this is the way of shaitan. If any person, any human being does the kibir, what happens? You see the Fir'aun, you can see, you read the history of Fir'aun, what happened? All, where is kibir gone? Person who is takabbur, who proud himself, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will put him down. Okay. وَمَنْ تَوَاضَعَ رَفَعَهُ اللَّهُ. A person who humiliates himself, saying, I am nothing, رَفَعَهُ اللَّهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raised him. Okay, and I think we can just stop here today. And then inshallah we go from here next week. And okay, now quickly. Hadith. Zadu Talibin. Okay, now Zadu Talibin, mashallah. Okay, hadith number 3 and 4. Who memorized? Yes. Oh, first hadith is Ad-du'a'u mukhul ibadah. Good. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Bil amana. Okay, who else? Okay. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Al-majalisu bil amana. Okay, Usman, inshallah. Okay, now from the sister side, two hadiths, 3 and 4. Very good, mashallah. And one more, inshallah. Okay, now go to hadith number 5 today. Al-Hayya, bismillahir rahmanir rahim, qala an-nabiy sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, al-hayya means the modesty, shubatun part mean from al-iman, so modesty is the part of iman. Modesty is the part of iman. Al-hayya'u shu'batun min al-iman. Qala an-nabiy sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, al-hayya'u shu'batun min al-iman. The modesty is the part of iman. Now this shu'ba is part of iman. So there's another hadith the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, if you don't have the modesty, then it's up to you. First, na ma shi'ta, what you want to do. Because no haya, then people now can see on the street, these kuffar, they do a lot of bad things. They don't have any haya. That's why they don't feel any, thing in their mind that people are looking at them. They don't wear the dress properly. Why? Because of lack of modesty. They eat haram, they don't care. They're doing all, filthy stuff on the street in front of everyone. Okay, they don't care. Why? Because of lack of modesty, because of they don't have the haya. So haya is the part of iman. If you got this quality, mashallah, then basically you got the iman. And Hazrat Usman radiallahu ta'ala anhu, subhanallah, astaquhum haya and Usman among the sahaba. Usman radiallahu anhu, that quality, he was the highest level of haya. The hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was lying down at his home and he was talking with the family, and his leg was uncovered, only the feet side, not the knee. So of course knee is in the aura. After that we call pindi. So Abu Bakr Siddiq radhiyallahu ta'ala anhu came. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was talking, he was lying, mashallah, talking to freely, and He did not sit down and cover his feet. And then Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu came. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was taking rest and he came and was talking. And then after Hazrat Usman radiallahu ta'ala anhu came, he knocked the door and he said, "Who is Usman?" Then Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, wait. So he asked the family to not open the door. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam sat down and he covered his feet, and then he was talking to him. Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anhu was surprised. "My father came." So he Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam didn't sit down and then cover his feet. And Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu came, and is this both? They were father-in-law, isn't it? Hazrat Abu Bakr Siddiq and Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And Hazrat Usman is the son-in-law. He's like a son. But Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam sat down and then he's allowed to come, and then he was talking. Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam after, "Why can you did like this for Usman?" Then he said that the malaika shy from Usman. Why Prophet of Allah not shy with him? To farishte unse sharmate to ke Allah ke nabi unse na sharmaye. Astaqum haya an Usman. And every Friday maybe you hear from me this in my khutbah. Wa astaqum haya an Usman. So anyway, had Usman is that on board this mashallah status. The second hadith, inshallah, then two hadith today. Al mar'u ma'a man ahabba. Very, very, very important hadith. If I start talking, hours and hours need to expand for this hadith. But inshallah, I'm going to say in 2 minutes. And then we have some zikr, inshallah. So, al mar'u ma'a man ahabba. A person, al mar'u means a man, person. Ma'a means with, good. Man means the one who, ahabba, he loves. Means on that day of judgment, a person who loves in this dunya, he will be with him or she will be with him. So if we love the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam much, then everyone, inshallah, we will be with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam on that day of judgment. Now it's up to us. We love to whom? If we love the good people, the pious people, the awliya Allah, inshallah, we will be with them on the day of judgment. And la samahullah, may Allah protect me and you, all of us, that if we have good love, bad people, misleaders, wrongdoers, and we visit them, and we love them, and we show our love to them, na'udhu billahi min zalik, then doesn't matter how pious we are, or we claim to like this, we perform the salah in the masjid with the jama'ah, but our friends are bad people, and we love them, we visit them, if we go to them, so we will be on the day of judgment with them. That's the thing. So make sure, do not have any love bad people. No, just only pious people, awliya Allah. Now, those who are alive, for example, if you have love with them, inshallah, you will be with them. Even though, let's say, if do not find any good people, for find any good people, awliya Allah, in this time, but you have love about our scholars, our ulama who passed away, but you have love and you follow them, you love them, inshallah, you'll be with them. We love the Sahaba, for example. We do not see his time, their time, but if you have love in our heart about the Sahaba, inshallah, be with them. And then on top of that, if you love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, inshallah, you'll be with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. You understand? So it is very important. The other hadith is, "An-nasu ala dini khalili." People are with their friends' religion. "Falyandur may yukhalilu." Now it's up to him. He makes sure to whom he's going to make friend. If I'm making friend good people, so we will be, our deen, our religion, our faith will be like this. If bad, even though we perform the salah, we go for hajj, we do all good deeds, but we have friend bad people, we will be considered as a bad person. Okay? So inshallah, that just we stop here today. Subhanakallahumma bihamdika wa ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta wa astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Yes.